MXC is back with more down and dirty action between educators and outdoorsmen.
All right, Kenny, we've got a great competition going so far. Two great games, and we're tied up 1-1. Kenny, come on, you're getting all giggly. What's going on?
Well, I'm thinking maybe this teacher thing is too much for me. It's too much pressure.
Well, there's lots of responsibility.
Yeah, I'm thinking the outdoors is more my style. Right. Fresh air, being one with nature. Uh-huh. Maybe opening a sleepover camp for hot chicks.
Kenny, I knew it.
How about a hot tub camp?
Let's go to the camp.
Get it on!
And starting things off with the educators is Edgar Allan Poe. Edgar teaches children's lit. He also wrote The Telltale Diaper, as well as The Fall of the House of Lego.
Oh!
I thought he was going to stick it there. Let's take another look at that, Ken. You can see he's doing a spread eagle mattress muncher.
With a full face plantation.
And to quoth Edgar, nevermore. And first up for the outdoorsman, it's young Candace Despiseman. She's a spelunker.
Oh, she vomits for a living?
She's a cave diver.
Took a dive right there.
Indeed she did. Yeah, let's take a look and see what happened.
Well, she overextended on a stretchy kegel. You gotta keep your kegels underneath you.
Good advice, Ken.
Hi, room 69.
And that's Ethel Grundy.
Here we go, Ken.
She teaches math and home ec classes. Either way, you're studying fine.
Oh, she ate a slice there, huh?
Shoot the gill.
Here goes.
Next up for the outdoorsman, Jack Packer. He's a licensed hobo who leads rail tours. Oh, there's a nice lazy stool into a 220 hummingbird. Oh, he totally tweaked it. Let's take another look, Ken.
See, that's not a lazy stool, Vic. It's a packed stool.
Indeed.
And now, he's packing his bags.
Vive la France!
Yeah, great. Let's Next up, VC Chirac. He's a forfeit instructor at the French Military College of Capitulation.
And
Let's take another look at that, Ken. You can see he starts off with good form, great extension, and in true French fashion, he ends it with his hands in the air. Okay, come on. Next up, it's Pete Moss. He runs a brown water rafting tour in Tijuana.
Oh, he feels right at home here, huh?
Buffet.
Yeah, I'll try that.
Here's Jody Macaroni, a lunch lady counselor from Boise Unified School District.
Oh! That calls for an MXC impact replay.
Indeed. See, she starts with a backside forced entry into an inverted Mons pubis.
Oh, it lands right on her pubis humerus.
Stink bait!
Next up, that's Virgil Crappie. He runs the world's largest nude charity fishing tournament, Asses for Basses.
Dude!
Oh! His ass is bass.
Well, and here's Kim Pica. She's a typing teacher. And there she goes. Comma, dot, dot, dot.
Boy, I hope she types faster than she does this.
Indeed. And there she goes. Oh, hits hard. Oh. Lands on her backspace in the paragraph.
I'm going for it.
Okay, last up, good. Hada Baba Ganoush. She runs a moonlight dromedary ride in the wilds of Dearborn, Michigan.
I like my camels with two humps.
And there goes Hada. She does a little reconnaissance swing. Starting off again, comes in for a second approach, and she sticks it! Let's take another look at that, Ken. You can see right here, she starts off that first swing, a sneaky peeky, swings back, regrouping her momentum, and right there, her stick-to-itiveness gives the educators another win, and they now lead 2-1.
Good for Chada.
Hell yeah.
Coming up next, watch our challengers ride the pole as MXC continues. Got it, punk? Time for more MXC. It's the outdoorsman versus the educators.
Well, Kenny, we're back with the outdoorsman leading 2-1 in a great competition, and I cannot believe what you were doing.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about those girls from your class down there.
They're just washing my car.
Yes, I know they're washing your car, Ken, but why are they doing it topless?
Well, I didn't want them to scratch the paint.
Oh, that makes sense.
Hey, Dances with Sharks, man!
And first up, outdoorsman Ryan Fossey. He's a marine naturalist who lived with a gaggle of sharks for the past 3 years.
He considers sharks his chums.
He does go, right under the drink. And let's go to the replay.
Right here, I'll show you what he did wrong. When you ride and pull, you gotta keep it rigid. Otherwise, somebody is gonna get hurt. Right there.
He's through ignorance.
And that's Audrey Salzano. She teaches world affairs at Sean Penn State University. And she's off. Oh.
Boy, I don't know how long she practiced for this event, but more would have helped.
Indeed, Ken. Let's take another look. As you can see, most young people her age have a short attention span, and right there, she just became bored with the whole endeavor.
Bigfoot's real!
And that's Jonah Sierra. He claims to be half Sasquatch from Moose Jaw, Saskatchewan.
Oh! And a Methodist, Vic.
Didn't help him there, Ken.
Oh, man.
Go to bed, kids.
And here's Nancy Shearer, nap time supervisor at Roseanne Barr Elementary in Nobenway, Michigan. And she's off. Oh, looks like somebody needs a timeout, Ken. Let's go to the replay. Take us through it.
Well, she has a nice start, then she loses her grip on the head and slides down the shaft and gets a face full of liquid.
One teacher that didn't make the grade. And next up,
Easter.
That's Lars Radishtop. He's Iceland's premier outdoor comic and Dixie Chick impersonator. You saw him earlier in Door Slammers, and here's what he had to say about it.
Yeah, it hurts real bad, but luckily my hair absorbed the impact.
Well, let's see if he has a little better luck here.
Yo!
Is that four?
Boom!
And Kennedy nails it perfectly!
Oh, he was born to ride pole.
Indeed he was. Let's take another look. Look at that grip on that shaft. And right there.
Oh, rides it all the way to the end.
That's the only way to ride pole, Ken. All the way to the end.
Get down!
Next up, Sherbert Tights. He teaches balloon puppetry to self-abusers. Oh, and he's also going to be our MXC Impact Replay. Let's take another look, man.
There you can see his years of self-abuse have weakened his wrist muscles. He just couldn't hang on.
Right you are, Ken. Let's take a look at it one more time. There is nothing more pathetic than a man who has overhandled himself.
I'll eat anything!
Here's Stubby Harrelson, author of the book Surviving the Mojave with only a spoon and a pair of panties. And there he goes. Good takeoff. Oh! Let's see that again. Good takeoff, good firm grip, good shaft flexing.
And there's the problem, Vic. He didn't land on the platform.
Insightful as always, Ken.
Thank you.
Free range love!
And that's Dr. Tim Cloven. He teaches animal husbandry and alternative livestock living. Couldn't keep his pole up, Ken.
My eyes! Get it on!
Here's Nunzio Spermicelli.
Forget about it!
He teaches witness intimidation and jury tampering at Our Lady of Tony Soprano in New Jersey. And he's got a good run going. Ooh. Oh, he goes down.
To nap with the fishes.
Indeed, Ken. And here's Shepherd Dane. He's an Everglades Sherpa from Texas. Oh, my goodness. Next up, Fran McNally. She's a dyslexic geography teacher from York New. And there she goes. She's got a good run going. And
oh, and does a longitudinal lickety-split.
Oh, my. And here comes Joshua Tree, big game hunter, developed the controversial kill-and-release program.
Oh, boy, takes a shot there to the solar maximus.
I think that deserves an MXE Impact Replay. There you can see, he just colostomizes himself, Ken. If you listen closely, you can actually hear the colon being inverted right there. No tearing, Ken, just inversion.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Having a rapper!
Here's Martha King Jr. She's an urban peace activist who packs a piece.
Yeah, she shoots counter-protesters at peace rallies.
And why not? Let's see what she does. Oh, Kenny, she's down, and she's getting hosed. Let's take another look at that in the replay.
Yeah, right here, Vic. Here's what went wrong. Wait, play it back. Right here. She let go.
Right you are, Ken. Good call. And trying to go all the way for the educators is Jasmine Whiffer. She's an on-set tutor for the adult film industry. Oh, she goes down.
Yeah, Vic, she goes down hard. Let's check it out again. She starts okay, but then she takes it face first down to the hairline.
Indeed.
Not only that, Vic, she's wearing elbow pads. You know what they say about a girl in elbow pads?
I think you're thinking of knee pads, Ken.
Oh, that'd be sick.
Is that Mark Muskie?
For my first song, I'd like to do a little ditty for the ladies.
Yeah, well, not now. Maybe on your show, buddy. Let's go.
And we still have no score. We could go into overtime unless Mark Muskie can do something. He's a bark number for a tree surgeon.
I guess you could call him an anatresiologist.
Indeed, Ken. But I think we're going to call him a winner.
Oh!
As he clinches the win for the outdoorsman. Let's take another look.
And he saves it up into a forced entry. And into a night prowler. And hops across the last remaining logs, and he makes it. Mike clinches the win for the outdoorsman.
I tell you, Ken, that's worth looking at one more time. And look at that, right there. Pops up right into some lumber lunges to the finish line and finishes with a happy little wood nymph dance.
Well, you dance like that in the wilderness, you'll get shocked.
Indeed he would, Ken. But we've had another exciting competition. All our players, a great job today. And I guess that leaves us with only one thing to do, right, Ken?
Yeah. Huh? Hot tubbing with girls.
No, Kenny, something even better. It's time for Kenny Blankenship's Painful Eliminations of the Day.
Number 10, Sherbert Tights, balloon puppeteer, is stretched, twisted, and rolled. Oh, look, it's a doggy. Number 9, Ron Rebar. This online shop teacher is bent, hammered, and rusted. Number 8, Candace Despiseman, a chick who just likes going down. Number 7, Ethel Grundy, math teacher. Ethel, minus 1. Bye-bye, Ethel. At 6, Tony Rubens teaches pacing for government employees. This has workman's comp written all over it. Number 5, Tappy Latorno, biology teacher / stripper. Most popular class on campus. And at number 4, Ron Muir, big game taunter. He talks a big game on the Stones, but he's man meat with the pole. And at number 3, Vichy Chirac, a French forfeit instructor who surrenders over and over again. At number 2, Joshua Tree, big game hunter, developed the controversial kill and release program. He's killed and humanely released. And my most number 1 painful elimination of the day goes to Jody Macaroni, a lunch lady counselor from the Boise Unified School System. She's going to need some serious counseling here, because she's holding like Tuesday's taco. Good eating. That's sick.
Yes, Ken, indeed it was, but it shows the importance of wearing safety headgear,
you see. Yeah, but did you see her legs up in the air?
Yes, I saw her like, Kenny, that's not funny.
Are you kidding? Oh, I'm upside down.
All right, Kenny, what do we always say?
Oh, yeah, right.
Don't get eliminated!